Wow. Yeah, come here, come here. Just a heads up, if you search Ma Raineys Black Bottom on the hub, you get a lot of different results. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to JBuck Studios, your home for reviews, reactions, and of course, ridiculousness. And we're jumping over to Netflix for one that has some sort of maybe awards potential coming later this year or early next year, and it's called Ma Raineys Black Bottom. Tensions rise when trailblazing blues singer Ma Rainey and her band gather at a recording studio in Chicago in 1927. So is this new based on a play movie one of the best that features some of the best performances of 2020? Let's find out. But before I get into my thoughts, let me know what you thought of Ma Rainey's Black Bottom if you've already seen this one or are familiar with the play that it's based on. Now let's get into some of the good. Yes, 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 like I said, we're jumping over to Netflix, Ma Rainey's Black Bottom, based on a play from the 80s, I believe, but also the play is based on the actual blues singer Ma Rainey. And you can tell from the beginning of this story, and as it kind of progresses a little bit, that yes, this is based on a play, because it is very much centralized in one location. And the thing is, it explores the various rooms from the recording studio to kind of the band room to a little bit of the outside and in the recording booth as well. So I liked how it was very much, it does feel like it's reminiscent or it is paying homage to the play of very much sticking to these locations and very much relying on the dialogue between the characters. And that's the thing, is you don't need big spectacle in this movie. It is the dialogue that jumps off of one another, the characters revealing certain things about the band members, Ma Rainey, the other people she's dealing with, and also Levy, played by Chadwick Boseman in this movie. So the dialogue is sharp, it is cutting, it is bouncing off of characters. This is very much a dialogue-driven movie, and I think that it does fairly well. Again, I'm assuming paying homage to the play that it's based on. But like I mentioned, Chadwick Boseman, Viola Davis, the performances in Ma Rainey are the standout by far. It is the spotlight of this movie because Chadwick Boseman is absolutely wonderful as this Levy character who is very much butting heads with Ma Rainey. It is, again, an emotional thing to see him on screen because this is his last live-action performance, but you can tell that he is giving it his all. He is fun, he is witty, he is conflicted. This is a tormented character that is very much striving for perfection in this roundabout way, but also wanting to get a piece of the pie. And that's the thing, is this character, like I just said, Chadwick does a phenomenal job, but it's the chemistry or the kind of lack thereof, or almost head-butting chemistry that he has with Ma Rainey, played by Viola Davis, who honestly is sort of unrecognizable. She has very much this gloppy makeup on, and she is a singer, she is the forefront, she very much has this eccentric style of the character, but she is another one that is very much turning it into performance of like, hey, I am the head of this band, I deserve the spotlight, no one else deserves this, you need to take me out if you're wanting to be getting the spotlight or have any say in this band. So you can see the chemistry, or that butting head chemistry between the two of them, drives a lot of this movie, along with other little additions to the movie, like subtle humor that's running through this. Like, it's not all serious, there's some lighthearted fun moments, but also the blues music I thought was performed fairly well. However, Ma Rainey's Black Bottom, again, this is based on a play by the same name, I just feel like there was more to this movie that could have been explored. Like, we're getting a little bit of a background of Ma Rainey, we're getting a little bit of background of Levy, but we don't get anything about the band members. We get like maybe a sentence here or there and how they've been together and a few struggles that they've gone through, but I really feel like there was more to really get from these characters, not only our two main leads, but a lot of the side characters, from the nephew to the kind of girlfriend to even the recording booth type characters. They're just felt like there was something missing. I mean, this is a tight movie, 90-ish minutes, but I just felt like maybe there was a little bit more that they could have fleshed out for the characters, or the kind of conflicts or backstories that these characters, or I guess the struggles that they had to go through in this time period, in this kind of band. Again, it's my own personal problems with this film. I mean, even a little bit more of the music. I mean, I thought it was performed fairly well, but I really wanted a little bit more insight into kind of the music and the musician kind of quarrels that they're going with. But overall, Ma Rainey's Black Bottom is a wonderful adaptation from play to the big screen, with it again being a great transition, performances, dialogue that is just so sharp, bouncing off of characters, and some music and subtle humor that works, but with it just feeling like it should have been expanded a little bit more depth into this movie and these characters, I'd recommend checking out Ma Rainey's Black Bottom. I mean, I had a fun time with this one, but the best thing, the one thing that you should watch this movie for is Viola Davis, but obviously Chadwick Boseman, because he turns in a wonderful final performance. In closing, I'm going to give Ma Rainey's Black Bottom 3.7 out of 5 Blues Trumpet. So what did you all think of Ma Rainey's Black Bottom? If you've already seen this one, or very much now looking forward to it, especially for Chadwick Boseman's performance, I want to know, really, let me know what you thought of it in the comments down below. Anyways, though, as always, thank you so much for watching. Watch some more videos up there, or right over there, you know, brand new content every single week here on the JBuck Studios channel. I'm working on some more of those first-time reaction videos, so stay tuned. There's a lot of work that gets put into those, but follow me on TikTok. I'm doing a lot of fun movie and comedy-centric stuff over there. Follow all of my social media down there. Like this video, subscribe to the JBuck Studios channel, and until next time, we'll see you later.